Hello everybody and welcome back to Viscera Cleanup Detail, where we are viscerally cleaning up all of the details. It doesn't want to be flippy floppy for me anymore. We've got all the blood, so no mop talk today. Sheathe your mops, boys. We're going to be using the laser. We got a bunch of boxes to move. I'd really like to get this one completely donezo today. So come here, Mr. Broom. I don't think I'll need you, but just in case. Right, these are bullet casings, so we don't need to burn those. We're going to need to use those later. And that is a little bit of garbage there. I missed when I was doing my burn. We did the burn already, and it was actually pretty good. I was kind of impressed. I think that the scorch marks and stuff stayed pretty well self-contained. I can use this to transport some of these things, etc., but these ones are actually pretty close to this area over here anyway, so I'm not going to bother. I think there is a little bit of trash back here, perhaps. I'd like to come and check. We're going to have a lot of these. We have to move all these crates. I don't think we have anywhere to put the barrels, though, so we just kind of got to leave those facing upright. I suppose you probably maybe should go in there. Please? Please? So, what? My face. My face. Oh, good. It didn't make a mess. It just... it's on me now. Fun. So, what's up with the lack of videos, Jeff? Where are my uploads? Well, I've unfortunately run into a pretty serious problem with Silent Hunter 3 where I'm frequently getting crashes. I'm gonna go with all the time. And I tried, for example, today is Tuesday, I tried to record Silent Hunter 3 for about 6 hours. It's 5 o'clock in the evening right now. I've been trying all day, and I ended up with about 45 minutes of usable video. And it was all me being really frustrated because I had already recorded a bunch of stuff and it was good, but the game crashed, so it didn't count, and I had to start the patrol over. I ended up doing that same patrol 3 times, and so you know what? I deleted it. I deleted those videos. I'm not going to upload them. So why am I not uploading? Well, sometimes it just doesn't work. Sometimes you just got to say no. I'd rather not have a video today than have a video of me being salty about something that's not your fault and you shouldn't have to worry about. That's on me. So, yeah, this thing doesn't actually have a home. There's no stacking area for it here, but I'm not going to burn it. I thought there would be more little things, but it looks like all we have left is the bullet casings and the boxes, and that's amazing. I hope there wasn't anything important in that. I thought it was paper cups and stuff. So these guys are mostly stacked correctly. This is medical waste, so they're in the right spot. It's just that some of them are a little too far back and not over the line. No, wait. I changed my mind. Please, no. You can't burn cryogenic supplies. That'd be really weird. So we'll just put the cryo stuff over here for now. I may leave the rest of the cryo stuff in the hallways, but we do need to move the medical boxes and the medical waste boxes, too. And in fact, actually, I think back here... excuse me. Man, those things are death traps, I'm telling you. Was there a stacking area here? Maybe... I don't think so. This yellow line looks like it might somehow be a stacking area, but I don't see a label. So I can't really assume that it is a stacking area. That's really unfortunate. Okay, well, we're just gonna keep going on with the plan. Pretend that that is not important. If you have motion sickness, again, this is probably not the video for you, because there's going to be a whole lot of me hucking and chucking. But you know what? If you have motion sickness and you like polka and, what is this, chemical roach disco? I don't know. Cut my box into pieces. This is my viscera. Different papa, different roach. It's kind of intense for box hucking. I don't know, I feel like I should be going for a high score or something like that. Rejected! Oh! Off the backboard! Alley-oop to himself. What, you guys aren't down with the hoopskit ball? No? I actually streamed NBA 2K12 a little bit. And people kind of liked it. It might have been 11 or something like that. I don't know, it's hard to keep up with them anymore. There's too many of them. Yet another weird company doing weird things. So a lot of that stuff didn't get moved very far, but we got all this, all that, and all of this area cleaned out. I feel pretty good about our potatoes here. Could I move something up there? I haven't found any kind of secrets yet, and I'm a little worried about that. For a number of reasons. One of those reasons being, I like secrets and finding things. Hucking boxes is a close second, though. That floor sign we probably will just leave here. I don't think anybody really cares about wet floor signs being left behind by a janitor. Usually I would imagine they'd appreciate that, particularly if the floor was somewhat wet. It's a rare skill, being able to throw things in Viscera. It takes a lot of practice, and you can tell I need more practice. Oh, jeez. It's not helpful that this hallway is obstructed by a very nice, I love you, Slosh-O-Matic. You're the best Slosh-O-Matic. You made very few limbs, and you know what? That matters to me, buddy. I'm not mad. Alright, so we got these two notes here. I'll put those by the clock-out machine. I don't know. I think that there's a chance that we could actually get this one done today. We've got all the information stuff ready to be counted and entered into the records, except for one thing. I just realized I didn't count how many aliens there were, if there were any. There's none in that. That's a cryo chamber, like the one that we had in cryogenesis. That one appears to have never been occupied. I think all I saw was blood and human parts. I don't recall cleaning up any actual alien bits unless they were up there and already there. What's this here? Jungle Baz Bongo in the Congo? Crank it. I'm ready. Alright, let's get these med kits printed out. There's quite a few of them here. This part's a nice, satisfying part. Just checking stuff off of a list, easily doing it once, not having to worry about repeating them footsteps. Gotta love it. And besides, we need to chuck a bunch of stuff this way anyway, so one of the things we chuck in might as well be medkits. Or... okay. Did it make another one? No. Oops. It's possibly too many. Maybe the game's trying to tell me something. The ultimate shovel! The new space shovel is everything a planetary workforce needs. Shovels in space! So let's see here. This one's empty. Was there one back here? No. Are there any crates back here I need to move? Possibly these are medical waste, but I doubt it. I think these are more just regular waste. And also, they will explode if I put them in the incinerator. So be wary of that. But there was no medical kit back there. Such lovely bing-bongs. I hope you guys can hear that correctly. I have had some weird issues with the audio levels of the music. So there's one more, and I think we did print out maybe enough? No, not quite. Okay. You know what? I bet this will probably take a little bit longer than this one video because of the sniffing we're gonna have to do. So I'm gonna try to hurry up a little bit. Wait, this area was a stacking area too. This is just regular crates. Okay, so we do need to move those crates. Those guys don't have a home, but the actual crates like this one, they definitely have a home. And there's a bunch of those in that back hallway we gotta move. And I wanna do all that before we do the burning, because if I don't, what'll probably happen is that the fire will spread to one of these crates and melt it. And it's really, really, I don't know. I mean, I guess you could just go put the melted crate slag into the stacking area and kind of be, it can be kind of an asshole thing to do. This used to be a crate before I melted it, so also, they're vaguely nipple-shaped, the slag piles, which makes them difficult to stack. How do you know? Have you ever tried to stack nipples on top of each other before? If not, what's wrong with you? The national pastime right there. Okay, that's all the crates, all the med kits, all the boxes. This area is secure! You can keep going. Now, we got the bullet holes, obviously, but those will entail with a little bit of mopping and some other things, too. So, let's just focus on getting all of our all of our stackies done. It looks like it all takes place in the same general area, so I should just be able to sort of throw everything in this room and then use it as a kind of a hub to just figure out where everything goes. These things I can try not to throw too hard, though, because they don't have to go very far. In fact, technically, we're stacking them already. Just really, really poorly. And these science-y hexacrates, those do go in the crate area. So you guys go over there. You guys go all the way over there. Oh! Kobe. Come on, here we go. And land face up? No. I would love to make some bowling games in this or something like that, but unfortunately the physics doesn't always pan out that way. Logically, I guess, I should say. Realistically-ish is a bit too much to ask. I almost hucked this one all the way down there. See, this isn't going too slow. We're 10 minutes in, and I know we haven't got the stacking done, but we've moved all of the crates into the right area, and that's seriously a big deal. You just gotta buckle up. Get her done. Ugh, God, so slimy. That whole meme. That's a slimy meme right there. It's not even rare, it's just slimy. Alright, you big guys are going to be the base of our medical tower of pizza. Our leaning tower of painkillers. Or whatever these are. Supplies. Oh, I see what's going on there. I was like, why can't I move forward? The rules. Tetris, Tetris, Tetris. There's so much room here, there's no reason for me not to put more on the ground. Everything must go in its place. Everything has a place in the world. This is the square peg in the round hole test. We're doing okay so far. So far, but I could slip up at any minute. What if they throw one of those diamond-shaped pegs in there, man? Those things don't go anywhere. Even if you do have a diamond-shaped hole, it's tough as hell to get it in there. Actually, you know, in a way, in the Kurt Vonnegutian way, Vonnegutian? We all have a star-shaped hole. Breakfast of Champions. One of the must-read books of an aspiring human being. Whoa. Close call. Yes, if you wish to be a member of the human race, I highly recommend that you read Breakfast of Champions. And also that you eat breakfast. It's the most important meal of the day, okay? It'll start everything out on the right path, and it all just falls into place from there. So these two over here, I will put them in the crate stacking area, just because it's yellow, I guess. That's a good enough reason for me. This is a huge stacking area, I love it. I don't even really need to stack, I can just spread. A spreading area. Sanitation Nutella. Everybody loves a good sandwich spread, right? I've never had Nutella or Vegemite. I assume that's a spread. I don't know. Like, nobody's ever handed me a Vegemite sandwich. Someone Vegemite, but they haven't yet. I don't think I have a lot of Australian viewers, but I might. If I did have a lot of Australian viewers, they probably would request a lot more upside-down videos, and they probably would have jumped more on my anti-spider bandwagon. Because they got some of the real deals out there. I don't know, do Australians believe in Spider Bro? Because I would imagine no. I'd imagine that they would believe in Fire Bro a little bit better. A little bit more. I suppose I could put these in the medical waste stacking area. I just don't see the point. Mostly I'm moving them so that we can see all the burn marks that we made in the floor. I take them as a point of pride. You know, you can't clean something without burning it a little bit, right? I don't know if that's how janitoring works. Super science crate there, and we are done. Oh, these don't actually really stack at all because of the handles either. We are done stacking. All we gotta do now is count and burn. This one's going to be a bit of a tedious one, and it's also going to be really loud, too. This loud. Uh-oh. No! How unfortunate that while trying to clean up a burn mark we had made while doing a burn, we made another burn on accident. I can't find my mop. There it is. Just pulling out random crap all over the place. Is this a mop? Is this a mop? It's kind of a mop. This may be used in the event of a lack of mops. You may use this sensor to slowly smack pools of blood into a cohesive group. So can I see all the bullet holes here? Yes. So this is one group of bullet holes. Let's just do the counting now. So we got, oh goodness, there's a lot of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the floor, 6 on the floor. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Oh, crap, I lost it. 5 on the floor. Wait. 6 on the floor. Goodness. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 30 on that wall alone. So there's another area in here that I think had some bullet holes. I think it was over here, but I'm probably wrong about that. There were bodies and bloods and stuff over there, but it seems like this is the majority of the bullet holes in this room, so I will allow it. And then this wall had some bullet holes. I thought that might have been one, but nope. Okay, so roof has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ceiling, roof, you know, don't give me a hard time. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I think that's all of them. So 12 more there. Oh boy. Let's just add these to this. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17 more? There weren't any back here that I knew of. There was some blood back here. 17 more. 187 on a motherfucking mop. Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Any outliers? Any weird ones? Any ricochets? Nope. 8 more. Did I put 8 or did I put 7? I put an asterisk. That's it. I guess if you look at that as a who knows symbol, pretty correct. Oh my goodness. Yo, this was a trigger-happy dude. Guy came in here with a lot of ammo, and he used all of it. Okay, so this leaned-up roof panel here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Plus this is 9, 10, 11, 12. And then we got 1, 2, 3 there. Wait. Okay, so 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20... 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. Forever! I'm gonna go with 44, it's probably pretty close in. Dear God, what is that? Contamination! Contamination! Purge! Purge it with fire! Purge the contamination. I'm gonna need you down here, but not right now. I think there is one more grouping of bullet holes. Here. Yes. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11. Looks like 11. All right, so the final count on bullet holes is we got 55, 85, 73, no, 72, Okay, I think I feel pretty good about all the bullet holes. I do want to make sure that this is not going to get toasted. So I'll put it right here where there's no bullet holes. Actually, I may no, I'm definitely going to need this for mopping up the ceiling. And I should probably grab some buckets, too, while I'm... Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Physics. Probably grab some buckets while I'm at it. Because I know I'm going to make a mess. I was just talking about how much I loved you, Slosh-O-Matic, but I caught the debris before it ever landed and made a mess. Dad reflexes. Did I actually get a bucket this time? I did, okay. I'm hopeful that a couple of buckets will hold me. I'm going to get three, just in case things go terribly wrongly, predictably, probably correct. Whoops. Don't spill the buckets. So yeah, we're probably going to need to get up there to clean up some scorch marks. But for now, I hope you can listen to and enjoy the soothing sound of laser beams and techno. I was gonna mute my mic and just let the laser do the talking for a little while, but this has already gone horribly wrong. What the hell? It's very difficult to melt these things. You can't really see what you're cooking at and when it's done, so you kind of just have to guess. Alright, laser beams and techno round two. Mother of God. Okay. This isn't gonna work. I am going to do this off camera, because this is gonna take fucking forever, and I want to get this done today. We're still gonna have to do the snooper and the sensing and detecting of stuff. So if we want to get this done in one video, I'm gonna have to do this on my own. I'm sorry, guys. I tried. Later, nerds. I'll be right back. After a while, you start to really get into a rhythm. And it goes a lot faster. And I actually haven't had a fire yet since the last wall. So I think I might have got the hang of it. It's just really all about rhythm. And you know what sucks? I can't keep up a rhythm while talking. There were some musicians who have done that in the past. All praise be to them. I'm doing my best, but I'm missing some beats. So I'll be back. Soon. Between that and this, there are 100 and... Uh-oh. I think it was 116? No, 126. And then this is 127. It landed just like this. It's amazing. I wanted to keep it to look at it, but... I actually completely lost count. It might be 107. I think it maybe is 107. Okay, so... That is about 110. Casings were about 116, so six bullets were hit. Maybe it was only 106 for the casings. I'll drop that down to 106. I don't know exactly. Obviously, I screwed up a lot of stuff along the way and got a little caught up in the process, but I was in a hurry. We're trying to get this done fast. So, are these important to our... This one's not. This is just the Corporal John Razor... Shot a lot of bullets here and kicked alien ass so much that there weren't even really any aliens left. Good for you. And then this one was Dr. Abraham Purulence developing the virus. Dr. Fiddles had a containment issue, feeding off the cells, killing the host. Okay. I gotta feel like I have a pretty good idea of what's going on here. We've done all the bullet holes, casings, information. So let's do a quick sweep with our scanner. See if we can scan some things. Now these barrels might need to go in here. And I could be missing out on a lot of points by simply not moving them a little bit. But I swear I did not see a barrel area. If this thing says barrel somewhere, I don't see it. But I'll put them in here anyway because this is kind of... Ain't got nowhere else to go. Is there like a... there's just no stacking area sign. I swear it looks just like one, though. You know what? I'm leaving that there. It's not tipped over. It's not going to hurt anybody. And if it's not trash, it's not trash. Now, this is just the non-organic layer that we're scanning right here. It looks for bullet holes, bullet casings, trash, scorch marks, these buckets of water, for example. Those are going to come up big time. But you can see, I got so good at the burning that, I mean, if I just go look at these buckets of water here, they're still clean. I didn't have to clean anything. I didn't make any more burn marks. Okay, so something's going on up here. Oh, right. This guy. I want to get a good scan of... I really wish this had not opened. It's got the last remaining vial of alien toxins. Am I flying right now? Oh, gosh, I was. What the hell? Oh, wow. Oh! What even happened? No, the notes. Oh, my God. Physics. All right, well, this is useless now. I was planning on taking this with us, but never mind. My broken dreams and a broken vial of alien toxin. Hopefully we can find all these notes, because if we can't, then we just shut ourselves out of being able to complete the Bob mystery at all. If any of the notes go missing from my janitor's crate, you have to start over completely from scratch and do all the missions and not get fired either. Not hoping to do that. So let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have no idea. What was the one that we got on this one? This one, I think. Yeah, the next sector we're going to is the waste disposal sector. Fuck these Frankenstein doctors. Okay, I think we're okay, aside from losing the vial with just the notes there. That sucks ass, though. I really wish that had not happened. I just wanted to get a good scan up here and make sure we're not missing anything on this layer. Something's going on up here. Oh, it's actually the medkit, probably. No? Possibly those buckets of water. I'm gonna have to get rid of those if I want to do a good scan. That's unfortunate. I just wanted to do a quick walkthrough, but... looks like quickness is out of the menu. This is gonna be a bit of a long video. I apologize in advance. I know some of you just do not care. But... I do... Oh, wonderful. It had to be that bucket that spilled. Of course. I should... What the hell is going on? Why do I keep getting rocketed around like some sort of... like a ragdoll? Is it because I have ragdoll physicses? Maybe. I think this gun had a footprint on it for a minute there. Alright. One more for the Gipster. Is it clean up here? Yes. It was those buckets that were setting off all of my sensors everywhere. This does need to be stacked upright, though. Maybe. That one probably won't go over too well. That's going to be showing up as garbage. So is that. But everything looks clear here. Okay. Looks good. No goopy biologicals. I like it. We can do the whole station run through with this thing this way, really. Something's... blood. Blood. Or some kind of biological liquidy substance. What the fuck is it? I just want to mop it. Please. Good nose on you, buddy. Nobody knows what the nose knows. Except for the nose. I think the nose knows what the nose knows. But other than that, nobody knows what the nose knows. Okay. I'm calling it. Biologicals are done. You're good. You were good until I knocked into you. You're good. You're cool. You're cool. F you. Put you in a stacking area. I feel pretty good about this. Starting to feel like a done deal. Very quiet in here. Gonna detect the this vial and the radio and stuff over here, but yep, I think we're ready to go. Okay, so let's start moving all this stuff out of here into a stacking area. It doesn't matter which one, really. Probably crate. This goes in the burnerator. I can also incinerate this, should I so desire, but I think I'll just put it in a stacking area. Like an adult! I don't need to throw a tantrum and burn it. The music was okay, it wasn't that bad. It was stackable, I'd stack it. Can you stack it? It's kind of a big qualification for me, if I can stack something or not, it's important. I have to make sure when looking at dating profiles that any of the women that I want to date are potentially stackable. Like, like human matryoshka. What the fuck? Okay, last thing is our crate o' notes. I'm just gonna put this in a stacking area as well. And then we're ready to do the paperwork and clock out and find out if we got fired and if it was all for nothing. I'm sure that there are some things that I might have missed here and there. I only hope, the only thing I care about, is that I didn't miss any notes. So that last thing it detected was the laser. And that is in a stacking area, so it's all good. Bingo, bango, bish, bash, bosh. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, another one bites the dust. Look at this beautiful, pristine, lovely, perfect, natural environment. I think we are all good in this particular hood. Let's do some paperwork. Close you up. I am donezo. I wish to do more. Okay, so this incident was... I'm gonna fill this paperwork out. I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I've finished filling out the paperwork, and I feel like everything's done. I also kind of feel like I really rushed this one, and maybe I missed some stuff, and I kind of feel like, I'm a little worried. But I'll go back and show you what I can from the paperwork. I didn't want to do all of that on camera. People complained about the visual effect of it, the way that looking into this computer with the glowy lines and stuff looks. So I'll only do this the one time. Piece of cake. Our worth method was I cleaned it. And our efficiency was catastrophically incompetent. I think I'm going to upgrade that slightly to evenly. So we had aliens, guns, viruses, military chemicals. Actually, no guns on the facility. Aliens, viruses, mutations, military. Maybe not. Chemicals, other. Other's a big one. Oh, right, genocide. There's a swarm coming, remember? These aliens ate everyone and then got killed real good. That's what I wrote is what happened. Alien entities presumed dead on site. Presumed dead on site is different than found their bodies, I guess, but I don't know. I saw some blood, but I didn't see any. I put 110 for the shell casings, 116 for the bullet holes, 350 for the total burnage. We didn't have a peer to report to. We're not part of a union that I know of. And I filled out all of these reports too, which, by the way, showed up perfectly in here. I think it was Runkle that got sucked into the vent. Yeah, I put liquefied and other... And for his, I didn't put incinerated, I put machinery. I hope that's correct, because we are done here. Let's go ahead and clock off and hope to the janitorial deity of your choice that we did it and got another employee of the month, because I really don't want to get fired, and it's a thin line between fired and employee of the month. I don't see one. Well, there's three of them, but we already had three, didn't we? 108%. Okay. Alright, there's our third facility then. I guess we didn't already have three. Now we got three. So we've done 100% on... That last one we did 108% on. Let's take a look at the report here. J Brizzle mops a lot and also drops a lot. So it took 3 hours and 10 minutes, which is a lot. It's about an hour less than the last one. Again, it real time, probably about more like 2 hours. You can count the video time there and figure out how much time I spent re-recording and fucking fixing video problems. 70% report accuracy is pretty good. Death report accuracy, 72%, is very good. Let's see. We can look at the individual reports on, for example, Mr. Runkle. How close was I on this one? 100% report accuracy. Wow, I'm actually pretty surprised. Method of removal machinery, liquefied and other. Yeah, you really can't go wrong with the other one, and all I saw was the liquids. So let's see here. What's the news? Hey, Gary. Hey, vagina tentacle thing. Exceptional performance noted. Inspector was most pleased. Asked to invite me to a closed ceremony. Award-winning dumbass. Hole sparks paranoia. Uh-oh, I left a bullet hole. A small hole in the wall sparked panic and paranoia yesterday when Dr. Morden Boundman first sighted it. Dr. Boundman, a known PTSD case, fled from the hole, promptly slipped, and then broke his neck. This hole, later discovered to be a leftover bullet hole from a recent outbreak, should have been cleared by the workday. Okay. Alright, my bad. Watch your back. One day, and that day may never come, you'll be cleaning when suddenly you're finding yourself stuck in an airlock or under a lift. That will be me. I've already read that one. Thank you. Hey, Rebecca. Hey, Mr. Freeman. What's the last one here? Darkness gains ground. Have hope. So I left a little bit of a scorch mark around. Wait, what? Did this last just as Mr. John Stevens' Fire Fairy did? When the darkness enveloped his life, we, as his fellow sprites who support him, gave him light enough to reach the other side and beyond. As those who left the dark black scorch marks on the station and gave the darkness passage, we must show them the way before they swallow us all. We must guide them with peace and love. Are they threatening to burn me because I left some scorch marks? I'm real sorry, guys. And here's the inspection report, genuinely impressed again. We did it again. And you know what? There's not actually too many left. We've got a bunch of notes in here. And we've done 100%. And this one was 103%. And then 106%. So we are not coasting here. I'm doing what I promised. I'm putting in the work. I hope you guys are enjoying it. And I will see you next time on Viscera Clean of Detail, the Hunt for Bob story, where we'll go to probably, I think, waste disposal. And I have no idea how that's going to go. So join me or don't.